Hello everyone, it's me, Gamesline99, aka No Brainer, and welcome to another Star Wars Destiny episode. This time, I am playing in the TTS League Season 2! Yes, that's now started. Do you remember back in TTS League Season 1? When I got into the first stage of the knockout tournament and then got absolutely destroyed by a Qui-Gon Rey, and they got really pissy and annoyed and then woke up the next day and absolutely hated the way I acted and had to make an apology video? Yeah, well, we're in season two now. This is again the group rounds. I think there's like six of us per group and stuff. And last time I was doing really poorly in the group round as a result of toss. I don't even want the cunning, I don't think. Let's look for a data pad or something here. Did not get it. Damn it. Okay, well, that was bad. Oh well. Last time I was playing, I did poorly in the group rounds because I played with decks that I hadn't fully. Okay, I managed to win, so I'm choosing his battlefield. I'm gonna put two shields on Java. But last time I played with decks that I was still experimenting with, hadn't fully tested in a tournament match, and then got destroyed at. So this time I've said, all right, you know what? I'm gonna try some tried, true, tested decks like Jabba Dooku, who I enjoyed playing before. I could not understand that. I'm sorry. It sounds like your voice is going through a voice modulator. This guy's freaky. You might have to be typing this out, mate. I cannot understand a word. Right, he's just going to deflect. Yeah, okay. Here's hoping that he's running dodge or something. All right, so I was like, you know what, Dooku, Jabba, I know those two decks well. I'll be able to use these two decks. I'll be able to use these two characters to great effect. And then I started looking at it. Let's do that. I'll disrupt his resources. That sounds good to me. Ooh, double disrupt, double discard. That's beautiful considering what he's got here. All right, he's gonna. Okay, well, that's a turn one Kylo's lightsaber, which is absolutely terrifying. But I will get to the discard the last two cards. In his hand, at least. Intimidate, and okay, that's cool because Intimidate was two shields. And then I looked at the deck and I was like, you know what? There are some cards I want to change. So I made the changes and I haven't practiced with the deck at all since. So, you know, I'm really good at this game. And practice makes perfect and all that lot, but eh. Alright, so he can do 5 damage this turn. With just by flipping that. So that is utterly terrifying. So yeah, that'll be fun. And I get another discard, and I'm a single melee. Okay, so this guy's probably gonna do about 6 damage to me this game. Okay, never mind. He's gonna do more than that because of the Java block. Okay. Do I discard and reroll? Yeah. And how much would I discard and reroll? I feel like I need to do as much damage as possible to this Dooku. Keeping the disrupt isn't great. Ace in the Hole is nice, but I'm not sure if I'm going to get enough resources to do a proper Crime Lord this game. Hunker Down gives me some health. Not a lot. Yeah, I'll discard Ace in the Hole. Reroll these two cards. A dice, should I say? Do I get? Okay, well, I got a resource out of that. That's better than what it was back before. Yep. He gets to reroll that dice. He doesn't have the resources for it, but now I do not have the disrupt for it. So that was really smart of me, I think, this game. So that's that. Let's get the resource with that. Gonna roll out the Kylo, sure. That is a terrifying start to one Kylo saber. You got a fo special and a blank. All right. Well, with that, well, he can't re-roll this stuff, so I can actually feel your anger to remove that 2 damage if I wanted to this turn. Instead of playing the force throw. The force throw is a 3 cost. If I get that out of my hand, there's no way his special can do much to me, so I'll play the force throw outright. It's expensive, but you know. Gets it out of my hand. Okay. And he hits a 0. Cool. And then I'll do one melee to this Kylo. With the, to this Dooku, sorry. Okay. You need to take 1 damage from Dooku. He doesn't have a card to discard. Alright, cool. Alright, and now I just played both Hunker Downs on Jabba, I think, and just tank up like crazy. Cool. Then I'll play another Hunker Down, tap both of them, get 2 shields on Jabba. Alright, and there we go. Now, of course, those 2 Hunker Downs between them get me like 3 health, but. Not too terrible. Oh, of course, I get thermal detonators now after I discard the ace in the hole, but you know, yay. Do feel your hangers. And he doesn't like you to deal with the to deal with the Kylo's lightsabers die. Okay, well, he tapped the lightsaber rather than the Dooku, so you know. But I did make some changes to this deck. I removed the underworld connections and something else. Okay, he got 1 blank there, but that is 5 melee damage that would be going at me here. I think I roll out the Dooku though and just hope. I feel your anger though does remove 3 damage from the board. A 1 to remove 3 is very good. Even though it's only 1 dice. I need my characters to live as long as possible here. Yeah, I'll feel your anger. Remove that dice. It feels bad as well because that would have costed him a resource, and now he can use that resource to ramp a bit better instead. But who knows? Maybe he gets a double blank here, and I get to. No, he got a special though again. All right. Well, at this point, I have 2 thermal detonators in hand, so that special can actually do some work. Also, that's 3 damage, so I need to use my hunker down here to stop the hunker downs being destroyed. Okay, alright, 50-50. He doesn't get it, he gets the 0. That is very unlucky for him. Very unlucky for him. Now I can pull out these, do some rolling. A 1 range damage and a focus. Interesting. He gets to deflect it if he's got a deflect. Okay, he does deflect. It costs him a resource to do 1 damage to remove the focus, the force throw die. But I'm kind of okay with that. It's not very likely that he was gonna do more than that. And now I get to do the second hunker down here. There, give me my shield. There. Come on. All right. Screw this. I'm gonna. I was. Oh, okay. I was lagging. Okay, cool. Well, okay. He removes, discards his abandoned hope. Okay, so this is Tiny's Dooku deck that he made fairly recently. All right. I'm gonna roll out Jabba here. I'm looking for the discard sides again, trying to mill this guy out, I guess. Get a blank on this, re-roll it. The Disrupt will be very nice to stop it to remove all his resources, of course. One thing about Kylo is that he has a lot of problems when he has no resources because he has a 2 cost. He has a 1 cost for 2 melee. And I can focus that to, I guess, the 2 discard. Okay. Yeah, that's not too terrible. I can also use He Doesn't Like You to remove one of those two melee da damage dice, but I'd like to keep that around, possibly. So let's focus to the two discard. Could have also taken a resource here. Would allow me to play the thermal detonator and then get another resource on the sec on the next turn. This point, my opponent's upgrades are very scary. But I have a lot of shields, and he's already lost one Intimidate. Okay, he's gonna discard Feel Your Anger to reroll. Gets the two discard, no resources for it. I can remove his two damage here in exchange for my double. I don't think it's worth it though. Alternatively, I hit him with the two melee right now, and then he hits me with the three because he gets to discard, claim shield, and I get to claim the battlefield and return one of the hunker downs to my hand. Now he might just not discard the card in his hand. He might save it for the reroll. But I think that's a good choice, actually. I'm gonna do that and see if he discards. Or if he just takes the three. I should have done this before I focused my dice, actually. Well, no, because he discarded a guard to reroll specifically as a result of me. Okay. And so he goes to another reroll. Yeah. Now I have a He Doesn't Like You to negate if this is a big thing. It is not a big thing. I can He Doesn't Like You here and not lose tempo to remove one more die if I wanted to. And then he only hits me for a one melee. Or I get hit by three melee. I kind of would like to keep He Doesn't Like You on him. So I'm gonna claim this battlefield now and return a hunker down to my hand and get a resource. And then I take the three damage. There we go. Go back to the start of the turn. I discard a thermal detonator. Do I discard the other thermal detonator? I think I discard the other thermal detonator. Because I need some better cards here. Get two resources, draw two cards. I got a data pad. There we go. And an electroshock. That's what I want to see. That's what I want to see. Alright, so first turn, I can immediately roll the force throw out in case of the Kylo Ren saber. Force him to respond to that. And I've got a He Doesn't Like You for the rest of the dice when this happens. So, there we go. Okay, I got two blanks and a focus. No, I got a blank, a focus, and a two discard. Unless he wants me to reroll this dice, if he's that annoyed that I did that. Because I guess by technical definitions, maybe I should have just rerolled it. I don't know. Holocron. He's just putting everything onto Dooku and not caring about the fact that Dooku's stuff is really, really hurting right now. So yeah, I'm gonna do that double discard. I'm gonna do that double discard. I'm gonna pay the one for the discard too. See if I hit those force powers. I hit an immobilize, that's a force power. It's a two. I hit the No Mercy. Fuck yes. Those are two amazing things to have hit right there. Okay, he's gonna roll him out. I do have, as I've said before, I do have a He Doesn't Like You to deal with the worst of this. He has, ooh, the four discard for two resources, the three melee damage. So I think I do, he also has a blank though, so I could do the He Doesn't Like the Feel Your Anger to remove the three melee instead. The four discard though would remove the rest of my hand as a result, so kind of there's no point saving the He Doesn't Like You if he's gonna resolve that. Well, the point of course is to keep the focus force throw combo out. But I don't think I need to. I think I'm okay with the He Doesn't Liking You and getting rid of the focus side there. Yeah. So He Doesn't Like You, I'll remove that to remove that three melee damage. Nice side. If he wants to discard four from my hand, he can do. But that would be effectively his entire turn at that point. Now I've still got the double hunker downs providing me an absurd value. Well, I'll have one hunker down provide me absurd value still. It'll cost him both his resources. Okay. He gets the electroshock and feel your anger. Alright. Now, of course, the thing is, I am losing all of my premium removal, right? I've got some quite dead cards in here. I've got deflects in here that are quite dead. The updated list will be down in the link. Well, down in this. There will be a link to it down in the description. Okay, it only resolves one of it. Alright, well, I'm gonna play a data pad then. Okay, he hits the shield side. He's got the special side now. He should know that the hunker down is in my hand, but just in case it's not, I'm not gonna play the hunker down just yet. I'm gonna roll out the jobber, see what I can get. Oh god, that is terrible. Okay, the two discard. That's actually the side I really wanted. I would have liked the special side on the data pad for the force throw, but whatever. The discard side was the main side I wanted to deal with here. Okay. You power the forces. Oh, I thought he was gonna power the force for three shields. That wouldn't have been too terrible, right? Dooku would have been on decent health. But he rerolls. Okay, he has a one melee side, and he has the Sith Holocron side. Now, if he hits the melee side, I lose the hunker down. He has the Holocron with the potential for a power here. Do I believe he has the power? Is it going to be one melee? But this hunker down represents potentially two or three health that I could still remove. Alternatively, if I don't discard this right now, he does another reroll, which could be a problem. So I'll take this. I'll lose the hunker down special. Okay, damn, it was an enrage. All right. If that was a Sith Hol if that was like a mind probe or something though, I could not afford that, I don't think. Yep, he does the one damage. I lose the hunker down. I could claim here or I could place the hunker down again. I claim I get first turn advantage once again. I get to roll out the force throw. Yeah. I think I claim here. I'm not gonna pick up the data pad though. All right. Four resources, immobilize, deflect. Deflect's not gonna be very useful here. Data pad, force choke. Cool. As much as I want to play these cards straight away, I do need to get this force throw dice out there as fast as possible. I'd no longer have a he doesn't like you, unfortunately, to, you know, deal with this damage. This is potentially gonna be a lot of damage that'll be coming into the Jabba. Then again, maybe arguably I shouldn't have done that. I should just started stacking upgrades onto Dooku right now because Jabba and just leave Jabba for dead at this point. But I don't want to do that, so I didn't. Okay, putting a Sith Holocron on. See, I could have definitely had time placing Immobilize and Force Chokes. I'll place another data pad onto the Jabba here. Now this is going to be a big rollout, and it's probably going to do a lot of damage. Two blanks. He's got the special on the Sith Holocron, but two blanks is not good for him. All right, I'm gonna roll out the Jabba then. Get that data pad up. Hopefully this data pad rolls. It's 1 in 6. We'll see. It rolls a resource. I got a focus side here. I'm gonna keep that. I'm gonna keep that focus side. All right, he's gonna Sith Holocron. Oh dear. Okay, he's gonna Sith Holocron, get Immobilize out. All right. He's gonna pay a resource to get it into the battle. All right. He can use an action to deal with the Immobilize side. I think it's just flat out better for me to focus the data pad to the data pad special than it is to focus to the focus the force throw directly, because the force throw will remain at the one disrupt. But do I want to discard two cards from his hand first? Well, I'll force the immobilize to be used instantly with this, so. Okay, he's gonna use the force instead. Alright, I'm perfectly okay with him spending a resource to remove one of my focuses. Is this the time I discard two from his hand? Or is this the time I disrupt one? He's got another resource on the field, so it's probably not a good time to discard one. All right, I'll discard two from his hand. Okay, he lost the holocron. Good. He lost the force training. Good. He's another force power. All right. He's down to just 10 cards left in his deck. He's gonna have a second No Mercy, a second Power of the Force. Those two I've got to play around quite heavily. But so far, so good on the damage side of things. Okay, he got two melee there. The Sith Holocron got his special again. Hopefully, he doesn't have anything that you know deals with that. I think I do. Moving his hand a lot. I feel like he's just trying. I feel like that's too obvious. I'm gonna disrupt the resource at this point. So that he can't activate that two melee. If he wants to discard to reroll, he's got a lot of blanks. It'd be good for him to do so. And he does. Okay, he lost his other use of the force. Alright, so he's still got a good amount. So that means at least the Sith Holocron isn't happening. But he's gonna be able to reroll basically his entire hand. His entire side. He might keep the resource. I would keep the resource if I was him. Because of the Kylo's lightsaber, having a three melee side. But let's see. This is going to, as I said, as I keep saying, this should be a lot of damage that'll be coming out here. I don't have any failed detonators. I still have an ace in the hole. I both have both of my cunnings. Okay, he is going to keep the resource. All right. Just gotta hope. Okay, he gets a plus two. Okay, gets plus two. He gets an extra damage from the power from the force choke. Okay, so he can do six damage this turn. It's gonna be a good amount. I can take the resource. And I can spend some turns putting down force choke and immobilize my own. Now, I also took the resource because if he's wanting to do the damage to Jabba, the best time for him to use the Force Choke right now is to just, you know, remove the thing. I'm hoping he'll Force Choke my two melee side instead, because I can discard from my hand for Dooku. Okay. Okay, well, I'm gonna put Force Choke of my own down now. A Force Choke who? This is what I wanted. This allows me to actually use the deflect for something. Damage-wise, I'm not doing too great here, but you know. Can now play the immobilize. I haven't used Holocron at all, but that's why I. You might notice I did not have immobilize in my other deck. Yeah, this is kind of why, because Holocron. It's a bit, you know. It's a bit difficult. I don't like having to rely on it, and clearly I did not draw the Holocron this game, so. Let's just resolve the one melee into the Dooku here. Could have re-rolled with by discarding Hunker Down, but I'd like to keep the Hunker Down. Okay. I can shield Jabba up and lose the first turn initiative. I'm going to keep the first turn initiative with Mos Eisley Spaceport. I'm going to return a data pad to my hand and get a resource back. This is why I love this battlefield. And then I'm going to immediately discard it before we start the next turn. There's my cunning and ace in the holes. Cool. Alright, so. Let's roll Dooku out. Still have a good chance to get a Crime Lord potentially here as well. Don't need to spend my resources much anymore. Jabba's gonna die and stuff. Okay, I did get the Force Choke. That's nice. Another three melee. Okay, I am watching him carefully. He knows what the last five cards are. And I'm shuffling so he doesn't know which one's coming up. Because I might just be able to mill like one or two this turn, or I might end up milling zero, as we see. I have Force Choke out, I have the Immobilize out, I can slow him down somewhat. Yeah. Then I can always Ace in the Hole my Cunning out. See if that gets a good result. You never know. Ooh. Ooh, okay. He's trading that out for a lightsaber. He's putting down some more damage. He loses a resource as a result. Okay. Do I just roll out the Jabba now because Jabba's got a good chance of being able to activate still, or do I put down the cunning on him and then have him die? Or do I put down the hunker down and then resolve it so Jabba's got a little bit more health, a little bit more tankiness? I think I just roll out the Jabba right now. I think that's what I do. Never know, I might get another thing. Like this force throw has not rolled well for me yet. Might get the special. I did get the special. Awesome. I'm not gonna take the resource, I'm gonna choose the double discard. Perfect, Jabba, you're rolling that double discard very well for me. Thank you very much. And I've got a force throw out, a force choke out. I can really, really hamper his dice here. I really needed that this two discard again as well. So I'm very glad to get that. Isolation, okay. He's gonna remove the two discard. Gonna remove the last resource from his hand. Alright, fair enough. So at this point I can put down the hunker down. And just be like, hey, I've got the threat. I'm threatening tank right now. There isn't really much I want to reroll here. I could reroll some of the Dooku die here and not do to not do as much damage, but yeah. Mos Eisley Spaceport is amazing with my deck. I love it. Like, Tiny was like, I'm putting Mos Eisley Spaceport in my Dooku Kylo deck because it's not always the fastest, and I don't want my opponent to have much of an advantage on this. This is the one deck I think can really use the Mos Eisley Spaceport very effectively. All right, so he got the three melee, so I am gonna do that to focus this to toss the three melee back into Dooku's face. He can discard to only take one damage off of this in total. Well, he loses the two shields, so he takes one damage total. Or he can just take the two. Okay, he's just going to take the two. That's interesting for me because he might die soon, and then I can ace in the whole Crime Lord for a finisher, potentially here. Still got Force Choke and Immobilize here to deal with any more rerolls here. This data pad worked really well for me this time. Rolling that 1 in 6 was really nice. And I love that Jabba's rolled these two disrupts. Like, it discards and the disrupts and all this lot. Like, it doesn't look necessarily like I'm rolling very well here. But I am rolling very well here. He shouldn't. And it rolled a blank anyway. Okay. I'd roll two shields. I might have thought about force choking, but probably not. He has two resources, can't dissolve them because of the double disrupt. He's hoping these both land on the two cost melee. He doesn't. Okay, he gets a one melee here. Sith Holocron did Holocron, which is a bit annoying, but oh well. Do I want to discard Immobilize for force choke later this turn? I don't believe I do. Let's just do the three melee right now into him. It's. He'll probably discard a card in order to not take all this damage, because otherwise Dooku's running really dangerously close to death. Okay, he's gonna discard a dodge so that he only takes two. All right. He could discard another one if he wants, but he's choosing not to. I think. I do kill him, Kyle is going to get the lightsaber. He has a good chance of getting the other lightsaber as well with his next hand. So he could replace the Kylo Ren's lightsaber with it. So Kyle is still going to be scary, but if I can ace in the whole crime lord. I know he still has an isolation left. He does still have a feel your anger left. Okay. What is he focusing to here? Through the plus two. Okay. Well then I force choke to turn that to the blank and deal one. Can discard if he wants, but again, it's looking like he's choosing not to. As Dooku's on two at this point. Oh, he discards to reroll. He discards the force power to reroll. Okay. He could take the holocron back to his hand and then discard the holocron later for a reroll if he wanted. But no, he's just going all out here. This is surprising me. He gets the special on the Kylo side. I have some two damages in my hand. Gets the three melee on the lightsaber, but that costs a resource, so I'm fine with that. The one melee on the Kylo is still there. Gets two shields on the Dooku, which is, I think I just hunker down. Hunker down, stop the melee side from breaking it. I'm kind of in a situation where he's going to be able to use Mos Eisley next turn. And by using Mos Eisley next turn, even if he uses the last card as a hand, he'll still have one left in the deck as a result. Okay, and he gets the zero again. He's getting very unlucky with that now. Sorry, but he is. Which is quite funny in my opinion. Okay, he's gonna focus that to a resource. Okay. I could ace in the hole a cunning here and then go for the force throw for three. To kill off the Dooku right now. That would be fun. However, I think it's safe for me to just not do that. Do I want to discard a card to reroll immobilize better? Because I'm going to be discarding this card at the end of the turn anyway. So I think my answer is yes. It's better than a straight up pass action. Okay, resource. Well, I'm kind of just hoping for the double shield. But it's not that big of a deal. Jabba just gives so much control if he gets the discard sides. Yep, disrupt two. And I guess do the one melee, and then I can either claim, and I'll can either get the resource or I claim. I'll probably claim. There are two Sith holocrons still in here, but there are also two crime lords. I'm probably going to discard the force choke to try and get the crime lords out. You should have a second feel your anger in here though. All right. He's used both his use the forces. He still has a feel your anger. He still has a no mercy. I've got to be careful of that. But I don't really because it's going to be very hard for him to kill me, but I've just got to keep that in mind. But he still has a feel your anger in there. I really could just look up the deck right now. Doesn't have a second abandon all hope. He has a second dodge. What he should do here is probably claim. Pick up the holocron. That way he keeps two cards left in his deck. He still has the second power of the Force. So he can still do a good amount of damage in hand. I think he probably has two Force Strikes, because I know Tiny uses those as well now for some really odd reason. Well, the odd reason is the fact that Kylo Saber can do three for two resources with it. So it's his turn right now. Gives me time to help further and analyze myself, right? Okay, so he's gonna claim. All right, he's gonna make the wise choice and claim the battlefield. I could ace in the hole cunning, try and do the three melee to kill. It's not worth the attempt. Gonna get a resource, and that's my turn. Discard the Force Choke, it's worthless to me. Draw three. He didn't even do the one melee for that. There's a Crime Lord. Awesome. Right, he's gonna roll out the Dooku. Got one card left in his deck, five left in his hand. Okay, he can focus that to damage. He can force. Do a lot of force shit. Can't kill me in one go. I need to roll out Dooku for the ace in the hole, Crime Lord. There's a blank. Alright. In the focus side. That's not great. Do have an immobilize, though. So if he focuses to melee damage, I can avoid that somewhat. Plus, he can Force Strike to melee if he wants. He's gonna Force Strike to melee. Yep. It's gonna cost him two resources, but it's gonna kill the Jabba. Ah! If I'd have hunkered down instead, I wouldn't have died to that. That was a mistake. I could have not died there. Could have not died right there. He's got Feel Your Anger still. So I don't want to roll in this Crime Lord dice. I can he doesn't like you the two melee side, the two melee. And get rid of my blank that way. I think that's what I have to do. Okay, you got the special on that. Fortunately, I can ace in the hole Crime Lord right now, so I don't take full damage on Dooku. Ace in the hole Crime Lord. Roll out Crime Lord. Crime Lord does not have a blank side. And it just rolls special flat out. Okay, don't even need to focus it. That's scary. He can disrupt one resource, I still got five. And I've got two more that I can collect. He's looking at a dead Kylo right there. Okay. Got immobilized for two. Actually. I should have discarded immobilize. Should have discarded immobilize. That way, he doesn't know what the last card in my hand is. This day, he can ensure that he gets two more damage off with the Kylo, if he focuses. But anyway, I can resolve this now, or I can focus the Force throw, which would be the smarter choice by far, because then I don't have to worry nearly as much. So, because he can't stop this Crime Lord side, so focus the Force throw side. If he rolls out a two damage, I can throw. If he rolls out another three damage, I can kill the Kylo. But It's not going to, obviously. So I have an Electroshock in my deck, which isn't very useful. Pretty much everything that's a 2 of has already died here. I've got another Crime Lord, which will be worthless. So I'm going to probably keep immobilized, stop myself being decked out potentially. Okay, focuses that to something that's the special side. All right. I think I blank that die. I think I blank that die. Yeah, I'm gonna blank that die. He's gonna focus it. Cool. That uses up his focus side, right? So what's important? I mean, discard to reroll. That would be hilarious. Prevents the 2 damage. Yeah, that prevents the 2 damage. I'll discard to reroll. Got a blank, oh well. I stopped that 2 damage. He can't. If he does a reroll on anything, he has a really high chance of killing himself because of this force throw that's out there. Can't force throw this to do damage anymore. But I can force throw whatever he gets. If he gets a 3, he's dead. If he rolls a 3 on anything, he's dead. Okay, he rolls a special. He rolls a 2 melee that he can't resolve easily. I'm gonna resolve 2 melee into Dooku, and then this, discard 5 onto Kylo. He can discard to stay alive. Discards the mind probe to live. Wise choice. Kylo's gonna die at the end of this turn. I'm gonna claim. And that gives me the claim advantage. The next turn advantage. Now I'll be able to get an immobilize out at the start, and that'll be great. One of the things I changed was I removed Underworld Connections for immobilize, and I was like, you know what? Underworld Connections, it takes a long time to pay off, and it's not going to be very effective. I'll probably be able to get enough resources to the Crime Lord if it ever turns up, and I have been able to, and I haven't really been focusing on getting resources so much either. So he starts the turn. He's on 1 HP, and Kylo's dead. And I am drawing 5 new cards. Of course, none of them will be able to help me kill. Oh! I forgot I play Backup Muscle now as well. I forgot I do. But I do play Backup Muscle now as well. So this is an even easier way for me to win the game. So I Backup Muscle. And that's game. He has nothing he can do. I completely forgot I have Backup Muscle in this deck. I'll take it. And that, guys, is why I have so many different win conditions. Crime Lord is the win. Crime Lord's the main win condition. Mill's the other win condition, and then I've got Dooku doing damage with force throws and force chokes and shit. But there we go. The dice were not very favorable to him on the initial rolls, and then I was able to punish it out until I got out the immobilize and the force chokes and the force throws and the data pads and was able to just completely control him. And then the Crime Lords came in for the final kill. Even on the untouched Kylo. Dooku, I felt, was definitely the correct choice to be going for that game, even though he technically would have actually died first if I'd been going for Kylo. Dooku, when you attack Dooku, it forces him to mill to keep himself to keep Dooku alive, and that plays into your other win condition very well, which means that Dooku's quite vulnerable in this type of deck. So I think I made some poor choices here, but I think I made better choices than my opponent, and that won me the game. And I like this deck. Link to the update will be down in the description below. This is the first time I've played with this deck from the update, and I am not missing any of the cards that I got rid of because I can't even remember what cards I got rid of. Oh, that's right. I got rid of Mind Probe. I got rid of Underworld Connections, and the Speeder Bikes. That's right. I got rid of those, and I put in Immobilize, Backup Muscle, and oh God. Why did I do this? Why did I do this to myself? I don't remember the Speed Me game. It's like, no, AK, no, Brainer. Signing off.